Hello, greetings. This is Gilles Mancier. I'm called to return today to continue to speak about transcendental psychology, the law of one, this pathway of ascension. For there's going to be a need for a mass consciousness evolution in education, in teaching everyone that we are eternal soul, that we are multidimensional being. For 99% of the population is not even aware of that. Although there is a 70% of the population on the earth that believe in some form or another in an eternal God, in a supreme consciousness that have created the universe. For the universe is far greater than anything we can imagine or resonate. It's when we look through a telescope, we find out that it's so magnificent, it is so big, it is beyond human comprehension. For we were created in the image of God, but God is infinite perfection, and our soul was created in infinite perfection. So it is a matter of understanding that, accepting that all things are in infinite perfection. As Spinoza said, life could not be anything different than it is today. From the acceptance of what it is today, we can move forward towards something that improves it, that makes it better. But as infinite perfection, we are created in this infinite perfection. But what steals our freedom, steals our joy, steals is the ego. The ego is the fifth. We are victim of the ego, whether it is our own within our own individual life or in the collective. For the ego drives the show. It is the ego that takes over the program, and the ego is completely unqualified to find joy, to find happiness. What we need to do is to let go of the mental process to move back into the feeling state. When we need to manifest something, we can work through our mind, project a vision that we, but the vision may be interfered with shadows when it is a mental process. So we want to move into the feeling state of what we desire and stay there as long as possible until it registers in the universe, and we move from potentiality into certainty, and then it manifests. And so we're working on that. We're working on moving outside for the mental body is like Hermes. Hermes invented lies. He had to lie in order to... So the lie is part of the illusion. It is part of the process of creation. But we want to move back into a state of truth, where we are sincere, we are authentic in relationship to ourselves. And for that, we have to seek the love within our heart. For love is really the... Love has to win the show. Love will win in an event. For only the soul works with the spirit. The mind does not work with the spirit. Once we connect to the love, the mind will adapt to increase its potential. For all things were created from the infinite mind of God. But the mind of God is very different than the mind of man. Even for the ego is connected to animalistic nature, where the love of the heart is connected to our soul and spirit. So we have to work with that. For the pressure is building and building and building and building. There's more and more and more pressure. There's more and more fear. More and more and because it's that world, it is the it is part of the plan that the pressure builds. So we let go of the fear. We let go of the ego, and we trust more the divine plan. For the divine plan is only known by God, but we are aligned. We are being taught certain things. I'm going to speak about precognition and retrocognition and precognition. So those are gifts from spirit that. For as we change our belief, the whole world will change, and in an event. I stopped watching TV for a number of years, and now I'm starting to watch again, and it's very depressing what they're showing on TV. It's extremely depressing. Don't spend too much time believing what they say on TV. It's all about the mind, all about the ego, all about the conflict, about the fiction that they pass here in France. It's all about murder. It's all about perversion. It's all about suffering. It's only that. So that doesn't mean you don't want to watch TV, but it's better to remain, maybe look for alternative news on the internet. It's still, it's being more and more censured by the big company, but it's still, there is still more diversity in what is being offered, and then choose whatever feels right, whatever resonates with your heart, and follow to balance out both the rational and the intuitive. And I'll pull a few cards. So the past, present, and future. Past, present, and future. In the past is our mission, for we've been given a mission. We all came in with special encoding, special, special drive and desires, and until we fulfill those drives and desires, our soul will not let us be at peace. We are called to do those things, and so it is our mission. We have a mission here on the earth. I have my own mission here. It's a cultural mission. I'll speak about this a little bit. Where we are now is intuition. It's about listening more to the intuition, for the intuition knows so much, and there's so much that can be revealed. And the future is apprentissage. It's about it's a learning process. We are being taught, we are being groomed to become ascended master, and so we have to follow the prompting of life, of our soul. What we're working on right now is healing. It's about healing. It's about for making situation whole, what is needed in any given time. For there is always two opposing sides, so we want to embrace both sides and find the middle ground, so that it will not satisfy those who are really, really stuck in their own dualistic belief, but the middle ground will satisfy the main core of whatever situation, and the outcome is righteousness. It's the law of righteousness. Once we align with that which is right, that which is true, then the law, there is this eternal law that is infinite perfection. For we cannot really achieve infinite perfection on the earth. It is nearly impossible. For there is always things to deal with. For it's always constant expansion. But we want to strive toward it. We want to aspire to each and every day to become better and better, to awaken a little bit more. For I wanted to discuss an idea that I wasn't going to talk about that, but it's because in a French video. In the year 2000, I returned to France, for I was an art dealer in America, but my project in New York did not happen in 2001 because of the 9/11 thing. And so I ended up restarting all my project from France, and I started writing all kinds of letters, sending packages with a catalog of my work and a description of my project. That is a project of creating a global culture, galleries in big cities of the world, and salon, artist salon, and in order to initiate this new renaissance, kind of global culture. So I addressed the heads of states and many personalities with about this project to prepare a golden age. As artists, we have to have the forefront of consciousness, and we can have the responsibility of creating a vision that humanity can follow. And so, and one morning I woke up with a vision of the Middle East, a state of peace in the Middle East. It was a divine vision. It is something that God inspired me from, came from the future. It showed me that the Middle East was at peace. And this vision was that Gaza was a state, a recognized state. Israel was a recognized state, and Cisjordania was a state that was made of a mix of families. And so I was inspired to write to the Prime Minister of Israel, to why I sent my catalog, my project, but I had it, all kinds of parameters that I was inspired to add to this letter, to say that, well, we can achieve that state, so we want to do it now. Even though there was a vision from the future, I was inspired to share that. And so I sent that, and a week later I received a letter from the Knesset saying, we share your dreams of peace. And about the same time, about a week later, I see on the television, at the time it was Ariel Sharon, coming to make a press conference, says we have all kinds of new avenues to explore in order to stabilize the region. So I say, well, maybe he got what God revealed to me, and I was sharing to with him. And also send a copy to Shimon Peres and Kofi Annan. At the time he was Secretary of the United Nations. And so, and Spirit says to send it to Benjamin Netanyahu. And I didn't see him as a man of peace, so I didn't do it. I should have done it, because now he's here. I should have been exposed to those ideas in any event. But I wasn't, mea culpa, I forgive myself not to have done exactly what Spirit told me. But so Ariel Sharon made this press conference, and then a week later I fell into a coma. So it's like poof, everything was buried down. But and then from the United Nations, they responded to me in saying, in order for this, those ideas are really interesting, but in order to discuss them on the floor, you need to go through the diplomat of France. And so I sent the whole package, and so in the recommendation of the General Secretary, I am communicating to you those ideas, and so I send it to the French diplomats of the UN to discuss that, but I'm not really sure, I haven't really followed what they've been doing. But the United Nations may become key in re-establishing this golden age and this peace. And so So this was the idea that the spirit and God can reveal us what's going to be happening, just as in the past life, there is this all, as we make the silence within our mind, as we tune into the heart, there is all kinds, our DNA is awakening to all kinds of past life memory, but is also opening our consciousness to be able to receive information from the spirit. That will give us step, and they won't give us everything, but they give us an aspect of what needs to be done in order to achieve this global peace, this global awakening, this global this paradise society that we are striving for the collective ego will not solve those problems, and eventually the galactic will come to assist in this process. For we all have a mission here to play. We have our, it's just a role that we play. We don't need to take ourselves more very seriously. We just fulfill whatever God is our inner self is calling to do. For there is a lot of people that believe in God, but they believe in a dogma, in a book, in a set of beliefs, and beliefs will not lead us there. For the beliefs guided us to see that there is really a creator, but from there we have to take it on from the heart. It is within our heart that our God self will reveal itself. Well, I'm just sharing ideas. I'm not saying that, but those ideas are maybe essential to the to what's going on, to what will be going on. For we are all evolving from a dualistic external perspective to a unified internal perspective. We are developing our own inner universe. We're all created as a universe, as a divine soul. As we descended through the dimension, there came a point in time where we were separated, men and women, masculine and feminine were separated, and ever since then we're looking for this balance between the yin and the yang, to find the harmonization between the mental and the emotional, between men and women, between the yin and the yang, between night and dark, between cold and hot. Everything was created in this dualistic function in order to grow, to evolve, to become more, to return to unity. Eventually we'll find ourselves as a trinity, or mind, body, spirit, or is already a trinity. The paintings behind me, this represents the ascension of the planet. It represents Mother Gaia, and around her she's got this aura of like all those little points of spirits that are in three colors, blue representing symbolic of the blue flame of power. The pink is the pink flame of love, and the yellow is the yellow flame of wisdom. Then he moves into the great I Am, the Emerald Heart, and then it goes into the galactic center, and all around there is all the major planets of the solar system. It's kind of an interesting painting. I kind of like it. Took me a few years to realize. And here it's called Behind the Veils of Illusion I Am, for the Beyond the Veil of Illusions is on the bottom. And then there is this person that can emerge out of the cloud of the shadows, this with a violet aura, and it says I Am in the back. You can't really see it from there, but it says there is a gold that it says I Am here. It's like a gold, a certain, you have to see the certain light to see it. It's kind of discreet, but it's the I Am behind the veil of illusion I Am, and it's emerging, and this person is standing towards the Trinity and the pink heart that is going in the corner. And so so I wanted to send greetings, and I wanted to come by and say hello. I hope this message was interesting for you. For we are, for now, we're still working through the parameters of the, it's the old world that is expurging all this negativity. And so, but there will be a divine intervention. The galactics are very close also. As soon as they will come, they will bring amazing technologies that will assist us. They're not here to enforce an agenda they're here to assist humanity in clearing up its own act, so to speak. And so the galactics that will be coming are serving the divine will. That's why they do not interfere. It's because God did not give them the permission to come in yet. But there will be a point in time, in one day, this first contact will change the world forever. For the highest wisdom for us today is trust and faith. It's about trust and faith. The more we have to trust, we have to have faith and to keep our faith very strong and solid. What we need to understand is finance, for finance will liberate us. Spirit is saying that finance will be coming. For now, I'm living in a extreme stress situation due to certain situation, and I'm forced to remain serene in the middle of this permanent crisis. So it's like I'm in a permanent state of crisis, where at any point in time everything can break down. But God is, but this faith is, I'm still developing my faith, and I know the finance will free when the finance comes. My whole program will be free, and I will be able to realize my project. And I thank God and all those who will be funding and collaborating and assisting me in the realization of those projects. And so, for there is, I do not know much, but I know there are many, many new friends that will be coming and working with me in this realization of that project. For there will be, and so right now, what we need to do is the Celtic. It's about working through the power of the elements, the divas, for we are all made of elemental. We have elemental beings that maintain our body, and we live in all the physical world is maintained by elemental beings. And the elemental beings, we have a diva called the divas, that is the supervisor, that supervises the coordination of those elements. And then there is a Elohim. We have a Elohim on top, that's the creator of form, he is God. And so this is part of our higher self. And so we want to connect and reconnect to the elementals within nature. And the outcome is persecution and inquisition. We have to let go of external authorities. We have to let go of fear, let go of all those memories where we were persecuted for trying to bring this truth into the world. For there was a lot of persecution, mostly in the West, in the East, with the Buddha, Confucius, and Lao Tzu. There's been a lot more understanding and acceptance of the higher wisdom, but in the West it's been really, really difficult to bring about this light into the West. So as we let go of all those, we can move through the arts. The result will be the arts. So the more creative will be more creative. We'll be able to work with all the powers, all the arts. So to bring through art the awakening of consciousness and utilize art, literature, philosophy, history. We have all kinds of tools, the mythology, astrology, tarot, all those are psychological tools that the arts were given to increase the quality of our life. So it is important, like my paintings are very, very new form of art. It is part of a new renaissance, deep spiritual, intimist paintings. And it's why it's so new. And so, but in my project, I will be able to start probably, they will start in a number of places, but Paris mainly, and at the beginning. And I will be able to show my art and show the art of other artists that are working within this flow, the flow of art that is about spirituality, art that is about the healing of the planet, that's about the awakening of consciousness, art that holds keys and codes to the awakening of consciousness. For sometimes some of those paintings are encoded. It's not my desire to encode them. It is my higher self that encodes within those paintings that triggers cellular memories. I realized that even little children love my paintings. A lot of colors, a lot of it's very round, and so but little children are very spontaneous. If they don't like it, they're not gonna tell you they like it. And so it is kind of nice to see that most children really like my work, because they don't have preconception of what is acceptable or not. For all those ideas are breaking down certain barriers of what is acceptable to believe. We have to bring into the collective consciousness through education this knowledge of the eternal soul, to know that we are multidimensional beings, that life is sacred and precious, and that we need to take care of it, take care of ourselves, and then to by extension to include all life within that field of recognition of that divine essence and nature. Well, I hope this message was interesting for you. I'm going to finish with a song. It's the song I sang it long time ago. It's a song by Bob Marley. Bob Marley was a philosopher. He made some very simple songs, but they were all very deeply philosophic. It's called Redemption Songs. All pirates, yes, they rob I, sold I to the merchant ships, minutes before they took I from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help me sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I've ever have Redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear from atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We got to fulfill the book. Won't you help me sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I've ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs, redemption songs. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our mind. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say it's just a part of it. We got to fulfill the book. Won't you help me sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I've ever have, redemption songs, redemption songs, redemption songs. Well, thank you very much for sticking till the end. I thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing, commenting. By the summer, I may move into a weekly videos, huh, because I'm going to have a lot of things to do. For now, I'm still going to communicate as much as I can. I wish you a wonderful day. Thank you very much, and I'll talk to you later. Namaste.